Hi children, we will have our beginning prayer. We love you Jesus, we thank you Jesus, we praise you Jesus, we adore you Jesus, we worship you Jesus, we need you Jesus. In the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit, Amen. Okay children, this chapter we are discussing about the church and the priesthood, isn't it? So today we will be dealing the relationship between the bishops and the priest. We learned that the people who are selected or who are called to be the priest, they are ordained by the bishops only. You must have witnessed, isn't it, ordination? You must have gone and you must have seen who lays hands upon them and bless them to be the priest. Yes, bishops only. Okay? They are the visible representatives of Jesus Christ. Jesus Christ only blesses them, but the visible representatives are the bishops. So bishops, by the laying of the hands of the bishop, they are ordained to be the priest. So, in all the services of the church, the priestly services, kingly services, prophetic service, and also the apostolic mission of the church, the priest actually assist the bishops. So, they are the true faithful collaborators of the bishop. So, they must respect, obey, and serve the bishops. Whatever they ask them to do, or the way they ask them to lead, they are supposed to do. Understood? Because the bishops are the main shepherd of the church. So they have to listen to them. Followed. When they listen to the bishops, actually, they are listening to Jesus Christ only, because he is the chief shepherd. Okay, now actually the perfection of the priesthood rests in the bishops only. They become the priest, then they will become the bishop. So once they become the bishop, the perfection of the priesthood will be completed. So priests are actually the faithful servants. Okay, the assistants of the bishop. So their sincerity, docility, and charity, the priest works in cooperation or collaboration with the bishop in everything. Okay, now who is actually the eternal priest? Whom do we can call, whom we can call as the eternal priest, children? Whom do you think? Yes, it is Jesus Christ. So the main celebrant or the chief shepherd of every priestly service is Christ, the Son of God. So the duty of the priestly service of the priest is to reveal the presence of Jesus Christ to the faithful people. Okay, through their gospel, preaching of the gospel, then giving the sacraments, then teaching, preaching, all this, through all this, they are revealing the presence of Jesus Christ to the people. So, because of that, we are also responsible to love, to respect, to follow the ordained priest. Okay, because they are exercising the priestly services in our church, exactly like what Jesus had done. Okay, now like them, we are also the priest of Christ. Why? Because we learned that through the sacrament of the baptism, we are taking part in the common priesthood of Christ. We learned about two priesthood, isn't it? One is common priesthood and the other one is ministerial priesthood. So we are doing the common priesthood service of Christ. So through that, we become one with Christ. Okay, like the priest sacrifices their life to God and to the faithful people, we are also sacrificing our lives for the well-being of the others. We are supposed to do that. Understood? So, let us carry out the priestly mission we received through baptism. How? By participating in the Holy Eucharist and also by receiving the sacraments. So through this, we help or we carry out our priestly mission. And also, along with the bishops and the priest, we are also a part. We are also taking part in the redemptive mission of the pilgrimage church. Okay, the church is pilgrimage, of course. Along with them, we are also walking. All are walking together. Okay, for the redemptive mission and also to get the eternal life and to be in the kingdom of God, to bring the kingdom of God to this world. We all are working together. We all are walking together. Okay, you know that this recently Pope Francis has coordinated one synod and the main objective of that synod is walk together. All must walk together, okay, in this pilgrimage church. Did you understand? And who will be our leader? The priest, of course. We learned the meaning of the word priest. They are the ones in front, leading us. So they will be leading us and we have to follow them. Understood? So the common priesthood actually demands what does it demands from us? That is to remain submissive and obedient to ministerial priesthood. Then only the church can run smoothly. Okay, when our parish priest asks us to do something, we have to listen to him. Not that questioning him or not going or not doing what he wants. His aim or the priest's aim, ministerial priesthood service, their aim is to lead us to God. Okay, through lots of practices are there, the prayers, the preaching, the teaching, then the receiving the sacraments. Through all that, they want us to go near to God, go to God. Okay, that is what they are trying to do. So, by mistake, people will misunderstand them and they don't want to follow them. But actually it is not like that. Our common priesthood service we are doing and they are doing their ministerial priesthood. This should work together so that we all can walk together towards God. Okay. And also the relation between, see, the parish priest and the parishioners is like father and son. How a good father leads the son to a right path. Okay, like that, the priests are also leading us. Actually, he gives, a rebirth to the parishioners. Through what all? Through the baptism, then preaching the gospel, teaching them, revealing them the presence of Jesus Christ, then sanctifying them. Okay, all through all this, the priest actually give rebirth to the parishioners. So parish priest and the parishioners, their relationship is like a father and a son, leading us towards the correct path. Actually, that path ends where? To God only. So we all are living here actually to go to God. Our aim is that, isn't it? We must get eternal life. So the redemptive mission of the pilgrimage church will be completed without any break. Only if we walk with the priest and the bishop, then the church authorities. Okay, children. So, what did we learn in this chapter? The priests are the people who once they are ones who stand in front. Okay, and they leads the people of God towards God. And we also learn they are an architect. Like an architect build or connects, he also build what? The relationship of a bridge between God and the people of God. Okay, and they are submissive and obedient to bishops. Like that, we are also supposed to be obedient and submissive to the parish priest. Then we all have to walk together in the redemptive mission of the pilgrimage church. So that is the mission of the church. Okay, so we have to walk with them. Actually, they are the leaders and we have to follow them. Understood? So we can do all this through participation of the Holy Eucharist and receive the Holy Sacraments and be submissive and obedient towards this our parish priest. Okay, children, so with that we come to the end of this chapter. Thank you for listening. God bless you.